everyone. I've got some words to encourage you during our 21-day fast, and it's words that I encourage myself with when I am fasting, and so I want to encourage you with these same words. Okay, I'm going to read to you from Matthew 4, verse 4. Jesus answered, "It is written, man shall not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God." Now, Jesus was quoting a scripture from Deuteronomy chapter 8. So I'm going to read the one in Deuteronomy chapter 8 that he quoted from. "So he humbled you, allowed you to hunger, and fed you with manna, which you did not know, nor did your fathers know, that he might make you know that man shall not live on bread alone, but man lives by every word that proceeds from the mouth of the Lord." So Jesus' point here is this. In our fasting, we're acknowledging that we need more than earthly bread. The stuff of this life, the things in this life, will only take us so far with satisfaction. You know, we hear stories of people who have so much money and multiple houses and many, many cars, and yet they are still unfulfilled people. And that's because of this point that Jesus was making, that we are both spiritual and physical beings. And if you sow only to the physical, you leave yourself hungry still, because we are spiritual beings and we have to sow to that. Okay? So fasting is our acknowledgement that we need more than what is just natural to sustain us. That we need what is spiritual, that we need God and we need his word, okay? So we are spiritual beings, and Jesus spoke of himself as the bread of life, okay? And when we fast, we're allowing our flesh to go without, so we're feeling cravings, we're feeling a little bit hungry, but that is so that we can concentrate on our spiritual cravings and what our spirit needs. And what do we crave? It says, every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. We crave his voice. We crave what he has to say. We crave Jesus. And what our fast is we're taking a set amount of time, special time, because we don't do this all the time, because again, we are physical beings and we need to eat, otherwise our bodies die, right? But this is a special time that we set aside. It's special. And in that time, what we're doing is we're weakening the flesh a little bit. You know, we're telling it, we're putting it in its place, and we're saying, I'm going to sow to my spirit right now the words of God. I'm going to be looking in the word of God. I'm going to be spending time in God's presence. I'm going to be listening out for his voice. And I'm going to be believing that I'm going to hear from him during this time. Because you see, just as in the physical, when we are hungry and we eat, all of a sudden we feel, oh, you know, like our physical bodies are sharpened up and our senses are sharpened. Okay, we're okay now. Like we could read that book or do that work that we need to do because our bodies feel strong. Well, in that way, our bodies are going to be a little weaker, but we're going to be sowing to the spirit, the every word that proceeds from the mouth of God, from the scriptures. We're going to be listening to great podcasts about things of God, and we're going to be doing that. And in that, our spiritual senses will be heightened. And we are going to, well, you should be expecting this because this is biblical. You know, men and women of God in the scriptures did this at times when they needed to hear more clearly from God. They would fast and they would take this time and they would sow to the spirit so that their spiritual senses would be heightened and that they would hear more clearly from God with no hindrances. Okay, so let me encourage you in this time of fasting. Don't look at it as, oh, I'm just so hungry. Look at it as a time that you could sow to the spirit and deny your flesh and say, be quiet, flesh. I'm putting you in your place. There'll be time enough for eating later. But right now, I'm going to sow to the spirit. I'm going to allow my spiritual senses to be so heightened that I can hear from God so clear. Because like Jesus said, you know, we need what actually fulfills us is every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. So be believing that you're going to hear from God very clearly. Have a great time of fasting. God bless.